Good evening everyone. So in this class we are going to discuss about frequency domain analysis. So the frequency domain analysis so here we are going to discuss about like a Bode plot, Pace plot as well as Nyquist plot. First we are going to discuss about the background of the frequency domain analysis. So actually in the several decades they are going to invent the so many domain methods. So this root locus, Bode plot, like so many things they have made it. So here this frequency domain analysis, it should be remembered in the year of 1932-1940s. So mainly this frequency domain analysis, it can be used to find the stability of the system. Without finding the transfer function, it's going to find the stability of the system. Okay, so here the frequency response methods were used earlier than other methods for stability analysis and design as compared to root locus methods and the digital computer simulations and literature on the frequency response methods is easily available over here. First, we are going to discuss about the mathematical tools. There are two things. One is the time domain analysis, another one is the frequency domain analysis. Time domain analysis examines the amplitude as time characteristics of measuring signal. But comes into the frequency domain analysis. Frequency domain analysis replaces the measured signal with the group of sinusoids which when added together produce waveform equivalent to the original. Okay, so the relative amplitude, frequency and phases of the sinusoid are examined. Mainly here we are going to find the gain margin as well as the phase margin. So these are all the things mainly we are going to discuss, and also in the frequency domain analysis mainly it will be used to measure the stability of the system. Okay. So in the time domain analysis, okay, so it input is expressed in terms of C of t. Okay, here it is possible to complete time response of a system if the nature of input under the mathematical model of the system are known. The time response of a system can be obtained by solving differential equation governing the system. So in the alternatively, the response of C of t can be obtained from the transfer function of the system and the input of the system. So mainly in the domain time domain analysis, we are going to find the value with the help of the differential equations over here. Okay, but comes into the this one like in the frequency domain analysis, we are going to find with the help of the sinusoidal form. Okay, in the time domain analysis, for a closed loops transfer function, the formula is the C of s by R of s. This is the Laplace transform of output by Laplace transform of input is equal to G of s divided by 1 plus G of s into Hs. So this formula already we have discussed over in the here in the block diagrams like a feedback loop. Okay, and then comes into the response in S domain, C of s is equal to R of s into M of s. Response in T domain, C of T is equal to inverse Laplace of C of S. Okay, then comes into the frequency domain analysis. Advantages, the stability of the closed loop system can be estimated. And transfer function, complicated system can be determined experimentally by frequency tests. Effects of noise disturbance and parameter variations are relatively easy to visualize over here. Then analysis can be extended in certain non-linear control systems. So these are all the advantages for frequency domain analysis over the time domain analysis. So mainly here we are going to find the stability. Okay, the main thing is the stability. Then whichever system, the transfer system is complicated, there we are using this frequency test, and it will be avoid from the noise disturbance and parameter variations. Okay, so here the analysis can be extended to the nonlinear control system. Then comes into the frequency domain specification, resonant peak. So it is expressing the maximum value of the closed loop transfer function, that is resonant peak we are saying that. Then resonant frequency, frequency at which resonant peak occurs. Then comes into the next thing, bandwidth, range of frequency for which the system normalized gain is more than 3 dB. okay, then next specification is cutoff rate. It is the slope of the log magnitude curve near the cutoff frequency. Then mainly the next two things we are going to find with the help of the Bode as well as Polar and Nyquist plot, that is the gain margin as well as in the phase margin. The gain margin we are going to find in terms of magnitude, phase margin we are going to find in terms of angles. Okay, so here the gain margin definition, the value of gain is to be added to system in order to bring system to verge of instability. Then phase margin, additional phase lag to be added at the gain crossover frequency in order to bring the system verge instability. Okay, so here to find the gain margin is used. To find the crossover frequency, the phase margin has to be used over here. Okay, so with the help of this, we are going to frequency domain analysis, we are going to find the like a Bode plot as well as Polar plot, Nyquist plot, and M and N circles. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about Bode plot. In the Bode plot, we are going to discuss about this one, stability, as well as Polar plot and Nyquist plot, stability, Nyquist plot, as well as M and N circle. First, we are going to discuss about the M and N circle. So here, the magnitude of a closed loop transfer function with unity feedback can be shown to be in the form of circle for every value of M. It is M circles, and if the phase closed loop transfer function with unity feedback is alpha, then it can be shown that tan alpha will be in the form of circle for every value of alpha. These circles are called N circles. Okay, so mainly here we are going to discuss about only the Bode plot, Polar plot, Nyquist Bode plot, Nyquist plot. Okay, so this is about the introduction of frequency domain analysis. The next we are going to discuss about the Polar as well as other Polar plots. Thank you.